Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to the People's Forum of Industries Meeting Interesting People with Big Stone. Today, we're blessed to be honored with the son of a legend. We're talking about the great Perry Henzell, or we're talking about Jason Henzell, which is the son, because the legacy of the father has been handed down and in care of the son. Welcome, my brother.
Hello.
We're at Jake's Treasure Beach in St. Elizabeth. A beautiful Monday afternoon. The atmosphere is fantastic. And we're here just to chit-chat with Jason. What's up?
It's a pleasure, man. It's a pleasure. And you're with a great friend of mine.
I'm telling you, a matter of fact, we're working on the documentary of Delroy Melody. And the way Delroy spoke so highly of this man right here, I said, Delroy, we could not do part two without driving all the way over the world to talk to you.
I'm honored.
Jimmy Cliff, The Other Day Come, his father is an icon. That movie has helped to bring the culture of Jamaica to the four corners of the world, because it was the very first time Jamaicans get an opportunity to see themselves back on a film or on television or anything that is moving. So as a little boy in the 70s when the movies came out, I remember I was in Montego Bay. My fifth joined the line from early, because by the time it get to 5 o'clock, solo Strand Theater in Montego Bay, you could not see The Other Day Come there because there's no ticket left. It was a sensation and still is. A matter of fact, it has propelled Jimmy Cliff to Sir Jimmy Cliff, and the boulevard, the hip strip, is now named after Jimmy Cliff. So thanks to your dad.
Great, man. And
how does it feel? How does it feel to be walking in those giant shoes?
We had a special relationship, you know? Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. And, you know, growing up with my parents, they were both artists. And, you know, I lived in Kingston, at 10A West King's House Road. But wow. We lived and worked in the same place. Mm-hmm. You know, my parents used to live at 56 Hope Road. But then the lady who owned it said, no children. So when my mother got pregnant now, they bought a property down the road. And that's where I grew up, man. And my father had his advertising agency, his production office. So, you know, being a child and growing up and seeing all these artists, all these creative people come to check my father, you know, it was just an amazing environment to be in, you know. And to experience that and to see the respect that, you know, they had for him and he had for them. And then, of course, you have foreign groups now as well, production companies.
His father was like the hub in Jamaica. Whenever you want to find anything that has to do with culture and talent and so on, his dad was like, you know, you have to go through the Henzell before you can touch anything else.
But when it came to film, you know, because they said that Harder Day Come was the movie that brought reggae to the world.
It is. And the culture of Jamaican people, the first time we get a chance to see ourselves in a movie.
It's the first time a Rasta had ever been on screen.
On screen.
Ever.
So it's this history in every aspect of the way.
Yeah.
And that should be taught in the schools, because history should be told. I'm like that.
Yeah.
What was it like when you laid eyes on Jimmy Cliff?
Oh my God.
As a young boy. What was this?
You know, I'm going to be honest with you. I was with Jimmy on a flight from New York to Montego Bay about 10 years ago. Mm. And I hadn't seen Jimmy in a while. And when the door opened for the plane, when it landed in Jamaica, the first person looked at him. He said, "Well, I'm Ivan." So I thought, okay, maybe it's just coincidence. Mm. We go to the end and go up to the immigration. "Well, I'm Ivan." It's about five people. I said, "Jimmy, how many people are calling you Ivan?"
Ivan instead of Jimmy.
Instead of Jimmy Cliff. He suggests that everywhere I go in Jamaica is Ivan and Bob. Let me tell you, I was surprised, shocked, honored. But you know, it's the same thing with Car Bradshaw. People call him Jose.
Of course.
Right now.
No, until this day.
It's coming right now. It's Guam Jose.
Yeah.
No, this is a movie. You know what I mean? So I'm trying to wonder, like, how many movies, like, close to 50 years later, right? And it's not to say them, man, they never have big careers. They had big careers.
But they were known actor and an artist.
So what I'm saying, how many movies are the known actors still referred to as the character of the name movie. In the movie?
Let me address those who probably don't understand. Ivan came from Ivan O'Martin, which was the name of a notorious gangster in Jamaica at the day. So when they called Jimmy Cliff Ivan, they referred to the character of the movie All That They Come, because that was the name of the character, not Jimmy Cliff, but Ivan. And then Huzzy is also the character's name for Carl Bradshaw.
Right.
The famous scene was in the gully when they said, I'll catch you! All right, I'm gonna catch you! I can't forget it. It was a joy, but your dad went on to do other things.
Yeah, man. You know, it's funny, I see you wearing a Marcus Garvey insignia here.
Mm-hmm.
My dad did a musical to mark the centenary of Marcus Garvey's life.
Wow.
100 years. And, you know, I remember as a kid going to watch it, and, you know, the amount of international recognition that it got. And,
to give a thanks for that.
Daddy just loved the Jamaican culture and respected it so much. And, you know, he said that when you went to Miami Airport, you know, you could see cultures from all over the world. Wow. So if you just look at the Jamaican warp, I'm just can't be friends. And hold up himself different.
You know? It's a total thing.
It's a different thing.
But you know, I have to touch on it because this is very important to me. You mentioned the fact that your father loved culture so much. And you love culture so much. I love culture so much. But some of us here in Jamaica don't really understand the gift that we have. So we fight among ourselves. We get involved in other things that is unbecoming of this great culture.
Yeah.
And we need to start doing better. Listening to some words coming out of Jason's mouth, his father, who is a renowned cinematologist, I would classify him. You know, we need to start to buckle up and show more love and utilize. Even the word Bumbleclaw is a festival.
It's true. I heard of that.
No, it is. Spice went overseas the other day, and I remember the Honorable Prime Minister. I'm not knocking you, Honorable Prime Minister, but the word Bumbleclaw is a festival somewhere there in Germany, I think. There's a drink known as the Bumbleclaw drink. Is that me saying that it is true? It's marketable.
So you're just making an example out of how influential Jamaican
culture really is.
Yeah, well, you know, it's not rare for people to take their own culture for granted. Mm-hmm. You know, and look at it even now with the ganja becoming legal around the world. You know, there are a lot of people who are coming to Jamaica and investing in companies and wanting to learn, like, from the Rastafari and indigenous farmers, you know, how much it means to them, and the fact that it's a way of life, it's a spiritual journey for them.
It is,
you know,
it is.
With the hard-working laborers in a cane field, or someone writing a song, or, you know, doing anything creative, you get me? So we Jamaicans tend to take our
culture heritage for granted.
But then at the same time, sometimes, you know, when we see the young Japanese coming here and they're going to a dance downtown,
Uptown Mondays and all those shows.
You know, I remember going to a session at Ding Dong Party.
Okay.
Down below the stadium there, Nannyville.
Nannyville, right.
And
Nannyville is not a pleasant place.
And all of a sudden, a minibus showed up with like 15 girls who were from like Russia.
You see that?
And when the girl them started dancing up.
You thought it was Jamaican girls dancing out there.
Trust me, it's like they had a different dance for every different song.
But every song. I see them at Wedding, you know, because, you know, sometimes they're up there Wedding.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we are at the famous Jake's Resort. We get everything that is great here. We're here close to the sea. As you can see, we took some pictures and showed them photographs to you. And we're having a chit-chat with the son of Perry Henzell, film genius, film icon, now transferred to the son. And we're just having a great time with Delroy Melody and, of course, Roland Burrell. Tell us a little bit more about Jake's. We want to know about Jake's. some people can come on down there and enjoy this. This is nice.
So Jake's is in the community of Treasure Beach.
Mm-hmm. Where the name Jake's come from?
So my mother had a parrot called Jake's.
You hear this first, ladies and gentlemen. Jake's, the famous Jake's, is named after a parrot.
One day she just look at the parrot and she just say, I'm going to name the place after you. So if anything go wrong, I can't get it. So as it turned around, now everybody call me Jake's.
Oh, they don't call you Jason anymore?
No. If you ask for Jason,
nobody know who that is. You remember, I don't know if you remember, what's his name? Johnny Cash did a song named Sue. The man who named his son Sue.
Okay.
Because he wanted his son to grow up as a fighter. Yeah. So if him give him that female name, it would force him to fight and defend himself. Yeah. You know, so look at it, the name Sue. So Jake's with the parrot.
So this is a fishing village.
It is, yes.
And my grandfather built a cottage here in 1941.
Wow. Right on this spot right here.
Yeah. Properties over from here. So then my mother now started Jake's as a restaurant in 1993, and then I joined her in 1995 and said, let's build rooms.
Okay.
So now we have rooms, cottages, villas, and it's also a farming district. Behind us is the Heathrow Plant, which is the breadbasket of Jamaica.
Right, St. James, so, they say it is.
Mm-hmm. And so, you know, it's a very productive area. So it's not all about tourism, it's more about
farming and communities and so on. How can people locate you on the internet?
So you go to jakeshotel.com.
Jake's Hotel, J-A-K-E-S, hotel.com.
And you know, people come from all around the world. I mean, a lot are from Brooklyn and Manhattan, Canada, the rest of the states. A lot of Jamaicans come here.
What kind of price is reasonable, you know, my brother Jake's, I mean Jason, makes it affordable so that Jamaican can come back home and enjoy the culture, you know, and we have to give thanks that we have brothers like him preserving the culture. That's why I keep a big thing down the road, you know, down at Spratt.
Jack Spratt.
Place, you know, where him keep it a whole part of the great artist from them times. So it is an honor sitting here and having a one-on-one chat. Tell us a little bit more about you, Jakes.
So growing up as with artists, you know, parents.
How did that?
I wanted a more stable life for myself.
How could it be stable with you?
Because it kind of freaked me out a little bit that both my parents were artists. I wanted something more stable and more secure. So I got into banking.
Oh, okay.
And I wanted to be a banker. That's what I wanted to be. And then I tried that and I loved it, and I did well at it. And then when my mother started Jake's, I felt my childhood memories of Treasure Beach coming back to me, speaking to me. And it drew me back.
To
her, no man, I want to come and join you and expand it into a hotel. From back then, you know, it was only really German backpackers who were coming to Treasure Beach. No one else.
Wow.
Maybe some bird shooters and weekends a year. And I said, I bet you that if we got the word out, you know, people from abroad would come. And in the early years, Chris Blackwell did a lot to help Jake's, but he had Soul Island Records and started a company called Island Old.
Big up Chris Blackwell, the Bob Marley legacy belongs to you.
Man,
so love, respect.
Yeah, man, it's true. So he had Strawberry Hill and Caves and Golden Lion. So he became a part of his marketing
collection.
So a lot of travel agents came, travel writers, journalists, and eventually the word has got out, you know.
And it's a very safe, if you look at me, I don't see any burglar bars and all that. It's a very safe community patrolled by the police, so you don't have to worry. You can come on down, walk late at night. And the food, I'm telling you, especially down the south.
Yes, man.
Down at Jack Spratt there.
Yeah,
I tell you. My wife came down there already about 2 years ago. I called her on the phone and told her I was there.
Nice.
And I had a wonderful time. The food was marvelous.
So, you know, I'm blessed to know that my grandfather built this house in 41, you know, almost 8 years ago.
Wow.
And so I'm now the third generation. Wow. My children are the fourth generation. To be enjoying Treasure Beach.
Wow.
You know,
And we're keeping it Jamaican, it's not going away. So no matter how much you think you know and bite outsiders, it is the Henzell property, and it will, from one, just we should do that generational projects. We should do it, and even like the Benjamin pharmaceutical, they're over 100 years old. So we need to keep it, you know what I mean? To the next 50 years from now, it's going to be an Henzell. The next 100 years, an Henzell.
So my sister
no sell out.
And Kwame Dawes and Colin Channel in the year 2000 started a literary festival called Calabash.
Okay, I've heard of it.
And it quickly became the largest literary festival in the Caribbean and among the top three in the world.
Mm. Are you still doing it?
Yeah, we still do it. We do it every other year.
Every other year.
So every even year. So the first weekend of June 2020.
It's coming up.
It will be 3 days of Calabar Literary Festival. Mm. We have Nobel laureates, authors from Africa, Europe, the Caribbean, all around.
How much room do you have here? You have enough space?
Yeah, no man, everywhere fills up.
Everybody gets a piece of it.
The play Treasure Beach just becomes
a buzzing tourist community.
Yeah, you know, and people are adding rooms and becoming like Airbnb properties. So the Calabash Festival, It's like it helped to put Treasure Beach on
top. Okay.
You know, it became, an iconic festival that you kind of had to be at if you respected the arts.
Thanks for that.
Yeah, man. So you have writing workshops that came out of it, and you know, it gave the authors something to look forward to launch their book and to launch their work, and you have open mic, which is a part of it, and you always have a concert on the Friday and the Saturday night, and then it ends with another concert on the Sunday. So it really gave a platform for authors and poets to highlight their work.
Anybody out of the family still stands behind the camera?
You know, my sister is a producer.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and she did a documentary called One People.
Okay.
That celebrated Jamaica's 50th anniversary.
Wow, have to go look it up.
So my sister Justine, is
big up Justine, anyway, you are keeping Dad's legacy alive. And as we speak, a little rain begins to fall, so you know it's a positive thing.
And then my sister helped to finish up my father's second movie, which is No Place Like Home.
No Place Like Home.
You know, which is a love story between Jose,
Carl Bradshaw,
and Susan Amaro, who was from a girl from New York, a lady. Mm-hmm. And it's really, whereas Holiday Come was more like a Kingston street kind of, this is more like a road trip around Jamaica. And a lot of Negril in the early 70s, when there was little to no development. So it's a very different movie from the Holiday Come. And, you know, make sure you support No Place Like Home.
No Place Like Home, I can't miss that. Justine Henzell, we can't miss the movie there. Yeah. Well, it's about that time. Thank you very much for your time. We begged 5 minutes, we're down to about 15. Okay. I mean, we're grabbing Jason. Am I saying it correctly?
Well, we haven't spoken about my great friend.
No, we have to. Yeah, well, of course, that's where it is. Tell us a little bit now about
Low Man Energy, as Delroy, you know. And whenever he comes into a place, it's like a ray of sunshine and love.
Wow.
You performed at Jack Spratt, you know, several times, and you know, you just bring such a love and a heritage.
Wow.
You know, you appreciate the music from, you know, in the late 60s, when we started out, 68,
right? Right, the J. Pop, Lawrence Miller, at the school.
That's how long ago you started that concert, Jason?
Me, I wasn't even born in time, it's 69.
No, okay.
The music he started.
Yeah. Okay.
So that's 14. What I'm saying.
Wow, that's great coming from me.
And I've been performing here probably about 6-7 years straight. You know?
Yeah.
The only time I don't perform here is when I'm away.
Right.
But as long as I'm in Jamaica. Yeah, man.
Put him on the show, we always have a big New Year's Eve show.
Oh, wow. Some
fireworks.
I'm impressed.
You know
one day I don't cut you. You know, one day, you know, you never know I was in Jamaica.
Yeah.
But him like, you know, step up his phone, like, it was, what do I think, man, you know, Roots Radix.
Yes.
Roots Radix playing. But I never have nobody to open the show. So it's like, like Dwight, I must say, I asked him if you have nobody to open the show. Like, I said, you want somebody to have it from my mind, you know, get a melody. What am I thinking there? But anyway, I take up his phone and he goes, bam, 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 call. And both two ring and I have my answer. And he can't believe some there. He said, boy, if we can't open the show. I say, yeah, man. He said, all right, make him talk to the guitar, the leader for the band first.
Yeah.
And hear what he said. And then go check Dwight. Same guitar opener. Dwight said, I like Dwight said, I wouldn't that know. And he said, they're right.
He said, I'm going to let you, man. I'm going to let you, man.
Tell the wife to call me and tell me the rhythm them way he wants.
Yes.
Yes, man.
But you know what we're going to do?
No rehearsal. We just come.
You know what we're going to do, Jason, since we're sitting here?
Yeah.
And it's raining a little bit. We're gonna ask Roland Burrell to give us a little piece of Stormy Night.
Oh my God!
Yes.
Because it says, "Have you ever been outside when the rain is falling?"
Yes. Yes.
Give it to us now, Roland.
Yes.
Have you ever been outside when the rain is falling? Yes. In the warm and the cold and stormy night. Yes. Have you ever been outside when the rain is falling? Yeah, yeah. In the warm and the cold and stormy night. Yeah, yeah. With not even a roof over your head.
And that's the extreme with it.
With not even a roof over your head. You know, bird of his nest. Fox got his den and the sounds of a man ain't got no home.
James!
Have you ever been outside when the rain is falling?
Blah, 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 we're on Jake's, ladies and gentlemen. We're here with Roland Burrell, of course, Jason Henzell, and of course, my friend Delroy Melody, and yours truly, Claude Big Stone Sinclair. What a beautiful afternoon.
Yes, Snapper. Yes.
Any shout out you want to shout out to Jason?
That's why, you know, shout out to my dad and all of the shoulders that we're standing on today who celebrated Jamaican, you know, film, music, you know, any kind of culture. And, you know, my sister and I are committed to doing something at 10 A.S. King's House Road that really celebrates the history of Jamaican film and the importance of Jamaican film.
Yeah.
You know, to honor not only my father's legacy, but everyone else who, you know, put Jamaica on the screen. Because, you know, not everyone can afford to come to Jamaica. So to be able to download something
right
done on film, I know, you know, he had a big part to play in the foundation of that. Yeah. So, you know, the legacy lives on and the work lives on. And it evolves and you have different influences coming in and, you know, here you are today, you know, coming down from
playing my little part down here, yeah, just to make the legacy, because that's what I believe in too, the founding father, those who have paved the way and leave that legacy, we should respect, honor, and honor it to the next generation, pass it on down so that we can still have that craft of a Perry Henzell, the craft of a Delroy Melody, the craft of a Jason Henzell, the craft of a Roland Burrell, and even myself, Claude Sinclair, because anything that we do, we put 110% into it. We want everyone to understand, appreciate, and enjoy. It was a pleasure. Thank you very much. It was impromptu, ladies and gentlemen, but thank you very much for understanding. We had a nice time. But guess what? Brought up in the thing, Delroy, him up in the thing so big. You can't get them a big talker from Jason Henzell and I put something in it.
We're gonna drop on it though. Yeah, alright. That new tune,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's midnight, you know?
Yeah.
Because, you know, yeah, big up on my sister, you know, Christine. Yeah. Because, you know, you influenced me to sing that song, you know? You see me? Yeah. It goes something like, I wanna hold you, squeeze you, love you all over. That's the way I think of you. I swear to you it's true. I figured by now you and I would take the vow. But instead I'm feeling ripped, lying in my bed. Questions in my head. But when all is said, Just remember, I'll take the love I feel for you with me until, until, come on, it's midnight.
It's midnight.
And I'm still thinking like always. You go part of the woman then, you see it? Boom, bang.
Ladies and gentlemen, there you
yes.
have it. A stormy yes. night Jake's at Jake's. Yes. It's midnight Jake's at Jake's. Yeah. And it's Big Stone yes. at Jake's.
Roland Burrell at Big Stone. Nina Rasta yeah. said so. Mama Claudette.
Nina! Big up yourself.
You know. Yeah, man. Blessed love.
Thank you.
Yeah, see your thing.
Yes.
Yes, you know.
Yes, sir. Yeah,
talk to you.
Thank you. You're going to Bible me soon and take out the little thing. Yeah. Yeah, that's what it's here, we're at the right. It's yeah. nice, you see?
Whoa, whoa, yeah. Whoa, yeah. There's a song. Hey, Lord, yeah. In my heart, presence, yeah. Oh, that's a life. I've got to play. In the play. Yes, you play in the Lord.
Sitting by the old fireplace,
with my favorite sleep day. I sing a few bars of melody and it sounded sweet to me. I thought I'd get up and take a look around, but my feet got in the way. Oh yeah, I stumbled through the floor, she was right in the door. I could see her face, but how could it be? She ran away from me, my best friend's gone. I'm so all alone, I really miss you, Brandy. When you're coming back home, hear a shot, hear some sound. I'm gonna miss you, really miss you, oh yes. Don't feel lonely, you're one and only. Right across the globe.